Fishing News is brought to you by Navionics, Okuma, Yozori, Evinrud, and the Star Island Yacht Club Shark Tournament.
Hi there, Toby Lapinski for the New England edition of the Fisherman magazine with this week's web video fishing forecast for New England. Well, I want to start off by reminding you or letting you know that this weekend is the 14th annual Fluke Till You Puke tournament, which is hosted by our buddies over at Big Game Fish in Rhode Island. Now you can get all the details on this awesome tournament right now at thefisherman.com. And this year's tournament is being dubbed the biggest fluke tournament in the galaxy. And you'd be hard-pressed to argue otherwise, with nearly 1,500 participants expected and the largest payouts ever offered. Between the many different Calcuttas, divisions, and ways to win, you'd be making a big mistake if you were planning to head out fluke fishing this weekend and you did not sign up. Again, check out thefisherman.com for all the details and sign up today. And speaking of fluke, there's been some pretty good catches being made this week. Waters of Block Island, they were really good a couple of weeks back. They were decent this week. Montauk has had some really good fish, but the waters off of Nantucket are slowly coming into their own. I got word of a couple of double-digit fish landed out there recently, so there's a few options. I even heard of a 12-plus pounder caught by a guy fishing shallow water on his kayak, so there's a lot of big fish around. And let's see, Fisherman subscriber and video contributor TJ Kopecki was busy preparing for the big tournament this weekend, which he plans to fish. Let's check in with him and see what he's been doing and how he's been making out.
Thanks, Toby. So hey guys, I'm just sitting here in my garage preparing for this weekend's upcoming Fluke to You Puke tournament in Rhode Island, which I'll be participating in. Pretty much just tying up some leaders, getting all my rods ready, checking my knots. Preparation is big when you're fishing in a big tournament like that. But getting on to the fishery reports, for the East Bay, it's been really good for bluefish on the Barrington River. I went on Saturday morning. I went out to try and catch some bait, some cocktail bluefish for the tournament so we can cut them as strip bait. And every single cast, I caught a cocktail bluefish. So if you enjoy catching blues or small stripers from the bridges, it's a great opportunity for anybody to do. Getting into the Mount Hope Bay, I was able to get out in my boat on Sunday, and I wanted to try a couple of new techniques of bottom fishing, just to see what was out there. And from sea robins to large sea bass, to even a keeper fluke, which I dropped at the rail. I didn't even get a picture of it. But the fluke are there. I was catching fluke in numbers. I was at the mouth of the Saconnet River, right where Mount Hope Bay and the Kickamule River is across from me, fishing right in there. It's just a tidal convergence. It's a really good spot for fish. There was a lot of bait in there also. I was able to snag a couple of pogies and fish for stripers while I was bottom fishing too. But the bluefish got the best of me. And I found that it was a little bit slower for bass this week. More bluefish tearing up your bait more than anything. But if you're going to get out there and you're going to fish in that tournament, good luck to everybody and tight lines.
Thanks as always, TJ. As I have noted in the past, if you want to contribute a video, a photo, a general report, whatever you want to my weekly videos, all you got to do is shoot me an email right now at tlapinski@thefisherman.com and I can go over all the details on how to get you started. It's super easy. I'd love to have you adding those reports along as we go. So shoot me an email and let's get started. Let's see, in case you didn't see the fishing log for this week for New England, which is posted at thefisherman.com, this is a quick little recap that I do every week to coincide with the debut of our fishing report on Monday. Well, at thefisherman.com right now, I have a post showing you how I received confirmation over the weekend of the season's first bonita, who reportedly caught out on Nantucket, by angler Paul Anderson. So it's the first one that's made its way to me confirmed here in New England this year. And he landed this feisty speedster while fishing up on a Nantucket beach late last week. And hopefully this is a sign of some really good things to come, as it's tough to beat the excitement of battling bonita or false albacore on light tackle, especially in the surf. And then also in the old warm water visitor category, when I was making report calls last week for the surf fishing report over the weekend, talked to my buddy Jason over at Bobby J's down in Milford, Connecticut. And he reports that kingfish have already begun to filter into the shorebound porgy catches, by local anglers. Now, every summer, it seems that I receive at least one, usually quite a few, what is this fish ID email request from local fishermen subscribers as they landed an unidentifiable fish when they were out. A lot of times it happens when they're fishing small, soft baits for porgies or fluke in the shallows. Well, there have been a couple that have stumped me and required some additional help and research. I gotta say, 8 if not 9 times out of 10, the fish in question is the northern kingfish. While these members of the drum family can reach a length of almost 20 inches, most of the common local catches are closer to 12, 13 inches or so. Now, the kingfish can be identified by its chin barbel, dark black or brown vertical stripes over a silvery gray body and a high dorsal fin. Honestly, to me, they kind of look like a saltwater mutant catfish kind of thing of sorts. And from looking into it and researching it enough times, getting these email requests, kingfish are pretty common in the surf to the south of us, but they've become even more common in Long Island Sound and all the way up onto Martha's Vineyard the last couple of years. Talking to guys down south of us that fish for them or catch them quite regularly, they tell me that they make both excellent table fare as well as top-notch striper and bluefish chunk bait options. So if you're out there bottom fishing this year and you get a couple of kingfish, hey, why not add them either to your baits or a little bit of table fare? Let me know how that worked out. I'd really like to know, as I haven't caught a kingfish myself yet, but it's as simple a fish as it is, it's on my bucket list. We'll see how that goes. And last up, I heard from Fisherman contributor Nick Kanaras this week. Sent me an email, said he's been doing really well on both striped bass as well as black sea bass. Start off the email saying that black sea bass bite is excellent right now, mid-sound, with lots of 20-plus inch fish being caught. Talked to a couple other guys who've been out for him this week, and they were saying that for the most part this week, they really noticed a change to deeper waters over in that Clinton area for the bigger fish anyway. Almost, you know, close but not over that New York line, as the season still closed in New York. But that's where they're getting the bigger fish. A couple of fluke mixed in. They're still having a hard time getting through the sea bass to the fluke. But those shallower waters, they were saying it's a lot more small fish. Still keepers, but if you want those real trophy dream boat class fish, you're gonna have to head a bit deep. And Nick also said striped bass fishing on smaller fish is really, really good right now in the lower Connecticut River. He's mixing in a couple of better fish around that, you know, 30-inch range or so. Sounds like still primarily on soft plastics, but he's been throwing a lot of topwaters, getting a lot of chasers, but not a lot of fish really fully committing. But nonetheless, real good action, and hopefully the best of the spring run is still yet to come, as overall it's been kind of a notch or two lower as far as success on the river this spring as compared with past seasons. All right, well, there you have it. I'm Toby Lapinski for the New England edition of the Fisherman Magazine, wishing you tight lines if you head out onto the water this weekend.
Win the incredible Steigercraft Evinrude Lowrance Grand Prize Boat Package and more in the Fisherman's 2019 Dream Boat Fishing Challenge. Get the details now at thefisherman.com.